step this visit to the Tappan Hat Railway was coming to an end. "We shall miss you," said Sir Tappan Hat. Then he turned his attention to all the other engines. "My railway is very busy. I'm pleased with you, but you need help. A diesel is all dead still. Please do your best to avoid any disturbances." "What does that mean?" whispered Duck. "That means this diesel is difficult," said Kana. And she was. "The diesels are very the shed." "Not bad. I've seen worse. At least you're all clean. The engine's glared. It's not your fault, but the top has to scrap you and get engines like me. A fill of oil, a touch on the start, and then I'm out. No bother, no waiting. I had to fuss around you for hours before you're ready. The engines were furious. Next morning, they held an information meeting at the turntable. "Disgraceful," said Diesel. "Disgusting," said Connor. "Despicable," said Percy. "Yeah," said Thomas. To say such things to us, cried Donald the Douglas. "It's to teach him a lesson we've been wanting. Now how do we do it? Their chance came sooner than they expected. The diesel was purring. The inspector watched the fitter making final turns. The inspector's hat. The diesel was ready. Look at me, Duck and Stepney. Now I'll show you something. He rolled out towards his coaches. Then it happened.
Shaking and spluttering, the diesel stopped. Meanwhile, the inspector was looking for his hat. The diesel seethed with fury as Duck and Stepney pushed him back to the shed.
My hat!
You sucked it through your air tank.
Bother your hat, said the top man.
The heavy train's due out. You'll have to take it, Duck.
Stepney, will you help, please?
Thank you, sir.
I'd like a good long run on my last day. Good long run on my last day, said Stepney.
The engine was soon ready.
Connor will take over from halfway, so get the train there. Good luck.
Don't worry, smiled Stepney.
We'll get there, and we'll be early, too.
The cavalcade moved carefully over the rails
and out to the open line.
Now for a sprint, said Stepney.
I'm ready when you are, replied Duck.
Soon they were whizzing through Diesel Station. And next they charged up Connor's Hill behind and beyond. They felt the drag of the heavy coaches here.
It was hard work.
At last they were running smoothly along the line between the big station.
Hack on, Bertie.
Hello, you're early, said Connor.
That's why I'm here for old Diesel.
So Diesel said he's smoking in the shed.
Fishing right for him, and Connor chuffed away. Next day, everyone said goodbye to Stepney.
Choo-choo, come back and see us soon,
whistled the engines. And you are always welcome on Bluebell Railway, too, replied Stepney.
Then he puffed away. What about Diesel?
He slipped out while no one was looking. But he left two things behind.
A rather nasty smell and a battered bowler hat.